Keynote speaker tonight is Howard Lyman. He's the founder and president of Voice for a Viable Future and a director of Farm. He is the author of Mad Cowboy, also known as Plain Truth from the Cattle Rancher Who Won't Eat Meat, and producer of the documentary by the same name. Howard actually did spend most of his life running a cattle feedlot and dairy farm, and has been making amends since then as the most prominent and popular spokesman for veganism. He warned about the danger of mad cow disease long before any of us would spell or pronounce encephalopathy. Several years ago, Howard's fame exploded when he won two food disparagement lawsuits filed by Texas beef producers and with some help from television hostess Oprah. Please welcome Howard Lyman.
You should never applaud for somebody until you hear what they have to say. Impossible to get it back. I want to compliment you. Tonight, there are 300 million Americans sitting fat on their ass. They don't have a clue about what's going on. They don't realize that the world is falling apart around them. They have no idea in the world what's at stake. Can you imagine our ex-Vice President, Al Gore, goes out and organizes around the world where 2 billion people participate and they talk about global greenhouse gases and the problems associated with it. Can you imagine in that entire event, never one time did they ever talk about the number one cause of global greenhouse gases, which is the producing of livestock? Not one time. My good friend, Paul Watson, wrote an essay. And he said, if we took a vegan driving a Hummer, would produce less greenhouse gases than a carnivore riding a bicycle. Isn't it about time? Isn't it about time that we look at what's really important? Look at what's at stake. We're looking at the future of planet Earth for the Homo sapiens, our children and grandchildren, to live on this planet with our addiction to eating meat. Are we going to sit at home worrying about a better job, a bigger house, lakeshore property, or a new Hummer? Or should we look at it and say, we got it. We understand. We're going to go out and take the multinational meat industry, and we're going to go out and we're going to take them to the map, and we're going to end up winning this fight. Don't kid yourself. They're out there right now grinning because they've taken this movement and they've dangled a few things in front of a few well-meaning folks that are out there. And they took it a little terminology. And the terminology really, really sounds good. Animal welfare. There's not a person in the audience here today that does not believe that an animal being treated better is not a good idea. But on the other side of it, once you get everybody pointed in that direction, what could be better than adding a little twist to it? That if we're going to really talk about welfare, that we're going to really treat the animals well, and they're going to be living happy. Why not kill them and have humane meat? I'm sure that those animals are lining up at the slaughterhouse, clicking their heels, and saying, "Yippee skippy, I'm going to be a burger tomorrow." Bullshit! There is no such thing as humane meat. Started that this game right now is 300 million to a handful, but we're winning. We're the ones that terrified them enough that they went out and started dangling all of the dollars in front of a few individuals in the movement that were willing to lean over, lay down, talk about, well, you know, a little slavery is not bad. I mean, we could have a larger field crate. Can you imagine when Alex started out, if he would have been out there and he talked about people, what we really want to do is we want a field crate that allows the animal to exactly lean around, see what its tail looks like? Where in the hell would we be? Cannot go and forget about what we set out to do. What we're talking about is we're not just talking about saving the animals. We're talking about saving this planet. We're talking about a future for our children and grandchildren. All we need to do as activists is the day that we die that we are able to say, I did what I could do. And if you don't think that we can make changes, ask yourself, how about that damn crazy ex-cattleman? I mean, if that guy can change, anybody can change. And remember, 80% of Americans are brain dead. They're part of the herd. They're following nose to tail, and when you follow nose to tail, there is only one thing you see in front of you. Forget about trying to reform Joe Sixpack. I mean, my God. He's sitting at home watching Rush on television. He's hoping he has an opportunity to vote for Dick Cheney for president. I mean, there's certain things you just cannot do. But don't worry about the 80% that are brain dead. Because when the majority of the 20% that are thinking decide where they're going to go, the 80% will follow. And so, we don't have far to go. When is the last time that you've seen somebody that walked up to you and said, oh my God, am I thrilled to death that Michael Vick was out there in dogfighting, because that's what we ought to have on every corner. We ought to give him an Activist of the Year award. Because he is going to generate more activism out there than what we could ever do.